in preparing ourselves to in teaching and learning for our upcoming class sessions. So set up for hybrid class, bare minimum, intermediate and advanced. So our speaker today, Dr. Syaril. So allow me to read Dr. Syaril's punya bio sikit. So Dr. Syaril becomes interested in the field of e-learning when he volunteered to be one of the participants in 2004 at one of the public universities e-learning project. Then with his background in software engineering knowledge, bachelor degree in computer science software engineering, he started seriously learning how to design and integrate e-learning with other education concepts and also with additional technical functions to enhance students' opportunity in their learning. His first e-learning project called Diskusi Maya. Betul lah? Diskusi Maya. So, let me besarkan sikit. Focus more for his part-time students since 2006 and also develop a new e-learning environment concept for selected teachers in Maya project. So he also will use a variety of instructional design and also blended learning in order to attract the attention of students to remain in the learning process. He had assisted one of the private universities to develop their virtual learning environment platform to focus on how the virtual environment acts as a collaborative platform to enhance the students' learning process. According to him, every engagement provided by the community, either lecturer or students in the online environment, is about building up motivation. So please welcome our speaker, Dr. Syaril. So over to you, Dr. Syaril.
Okay. Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good afternoon. Okay, so thank you Dr. Yazid and ADEC for inviting me to share. Okay, for this session actually I just want to share my setup, but I'm not in UUM, but I try my best to replicate lah the setting that I will use in my class. Okay, so before that, maybe I share a little bit slide sikit before I show you this environment, because right now quite complicated lah, because I want to share the technical setting and the other side the basic setting, and this one is maybe a little bit not advanced lah, the intermediate lah, because we use at least two monitor and another webcam that can follow our gesture and movement and thing kan. Okay, so I share you slide dulu.
Boleh.
Slide ni just a simple slide lah. Just, I tak nak cakap pasal teori, but at least I want to share dia punya philosophy behind all of this setting lah. Okay. I cannot start screen share. Somebody using screen sharing But is it? Mute.
Can you try again?
Oh, jap. Yeah. Oh, okay, can. Thank you. Okay, when we talk about hybrid, actually, we have a lot of design now. But when I look at our setting in UM, so I try ialah the basic setting, because frankly speaking, I'm not saying that that is the best setting lah, but at least we start some, we start something lah, because hybrid is not, yelah, if you see some these tools, it's very expensive lah, but I, yeah, for me, at least it's a good start lah for our university in exploring something, the hybrid knowledge. For me, I look it positively, and at least we start this hybrid things. Okay, so hybrid. Okay, hybrid. Okay, low cost. Actually, I created one. This is my previous project about low cost. Okay, low cost is something like the hybrid things, but I don't want to explain about this because this is more to studio. Okay, hopefully by at the end of this session, I can share several this thing lah, about a little bit about philosophy, space and online learning and the setup. The most important thing actually the setup, but for the sake of this session, I come up with this simple slide. Okay, first, the philosophy. When we talk about hybrid, actually, we need to be careful though, because before we select whatever technology we want to use, we need to be clear on the human factor side though. The human factor is something like the pedagogy we want to use, the setting, this environment, setting environment, class environment. We need to set up that that first during SOP sekarang ni pun lagilah we need to betul-betul set up this environment. Okay, and then the layout, class layout. Normally kalau kita face to face class, kita boleh rearrange suka hati, rearrange without lah, based on our design session, kita punya class session, we want to design. But when we talk about this hybrid, we really need to pin, atau we need to make it several area to default. They cannot change anything. Something macam this camera. If this camera, yalah, sekarang ni COVID, and then we move the camera around the class, nanti boleh jadi rosak. And then you just imagine the setup for the default, space. Dia dah change kan. So we need to understand lah. Dia ada a little bit macam tricky part lah. Not because we need to try to follow dia punya setup tu. So okay. I share you this screen. Why dia keluar the other screen? Dia keluar apa?
Sekarang dia keluar your slide. I can see your slide lah.
My slide ke ataupun slideshow? My slide kan? Bukan slideshow kan?
Yang apa ni, introduction, human factor, teknologi.
Bukan human factor dengan teknologi factor tu eh?
Yes, correct. Tak?
Okay. Okay. So, when you talk about technology pula, we need to choose the suitable technology lah. Not expensive, but at least suitable at the moment. Okay. at the moment. Because kalau nak kata expensive, if you have money, we can buy yang memang expensive lah. Itu advance lah. I don't want to talk about advance because I don't have any advance punya setup, but I just want to share the basic and the intermediate lah. At least the intermediate lah. Intermediate means we try to interact with the gadget around here. Okay. Back to human factor. When we talk about human factor, just imagine your marker also you need to you cannot use the default marker. This is the bigger one marker because when you want to explain to your student kan, you can use it yang the bigger one, and then when you write, dia memang definitely cuma tak biasa. Okay. Boy. Okay, the bigger one lah. So, better we have this kind of marker lah. So the human factor need to be clear first. Okay, human factor, all of this. Okay, and then, okay, that is human factor. And then the technology factor, if you can see, at least you need to have camera. At least one camera, okay, one camera, one webcam, at least one webcam. Kan kalau kata kamera, actually tadi ingatkan I want to set my SLR, camera SLR, but I've no much time to not set up. At least one web camera from the at the back yang begin yang paling basic tu, basic setting. One macam kita online class. One web camera, and then at least microphone. We need to have microphone.
Ini bare minimum lah kan? Webcam.
One webcam and one microphone. Microphone, wired microphone pun boleh. Boya kalau boya ke RM33 je. And then I tak encourage lah faculty letak satu microphone lepas tu semua orang pakai. You just imagine kalau wired microphone pakai, saya pakai, lepas tu Ailio saya masuk situ, lepas tu orang lain kedua pakai, so dia dah tak hygiene, and then COVID punya hal lah, so better we have our own microphone lah. Our own microphone, we can plug in into the audio jack, microphone jack, and then we can use lah.
Boleh suggest apa ni microphone?
Boya, I will suggest Boya.
Boya. Okay.
I didn't bring one Boya. Boya tu dia wired lah, wired. Something RM33 or RM35 je dekat dalam Shopee. If you buy at MCOT Mall, MCOT Mall lah. Kat mana tu? Loyat, dia memang my friends told me it cost nearly 60 something ringgit to RM70. So dia memang double. So better beli Shopee lah. Okay, so human factor one part, technology factor one part. Tapi human factor is very, the most important thing, the human factor, the policy, the SOP macam dekat depan pintu tu kena the layout tu kena ada dulu. Kalau tak, barang ni hilang, barang ni letak mana-mana, jatuh, orang terpijak, pecah, habis. Dia kecil-kecil macam ni pun memang senang rosak lah kalau tak jaga properly. So that is one thing lah. The human factor ni memang betul-betul need to be clear, betul-betul. The flow, dia projector. Okay. So how to, okay, sekarang ni technology factor memang teknologi je lah. Okay, teknologi nanti kita tengok bila dia dah set up, nanti kita akan nampak lah. Okay, so dia punya framework, first you need to ask yourself about your pedagogy, how you strategize your class. But for me, I think all of us can make it because we already maybe have some experience lah. Last year, we conduct our class online, and then we try to maximize our engagement online. That is a good start. Tapi kalau siapa yang tak pernah buat online since last year, then maybe dia akan ada konflik sikit lah, because at the same time you want to engage with your offline student, and then at the same time you nak engage online apa online student. So yang itulah. But for because when my friend asked me about this, I think I'm confident because our lecturer dia dah go through the online activity last year. I think almost one year and a half kan. I think that's a good start. That's why this hybrid is very important, because we want to explore more. What I mean by more, because maybe after this, if you want to conduct training ke workshop ke, maybe you can offer two package, offline and online. That's why we try to practice with this, yeah, this activity lah. Okay, so the pedagogy is very important. The pedagogy, that means macam face to face is face to face, online is online. So we need to be clear, betul-betul clear. Okay, when we engage with our student yang face to face ni, when I engage with student, hi, bukanlah dekat-dekat lah. That means kita engage with them. Then we engage it using pedagogy that maybe before COVID tu, last before COVID we use lah macam direct engagement kan. But when we engage with online student, then we need to have some time or some space lah, nak type or engage with them directly, pandang kamera and then engage with them. Actually kita nampak dekat dalam monitor, but we need to try to make sure macam we look at their eyes kan, pandang kamera lah. Okay, so the pedagogy tu one part, and then space is another part. Okay, space is first sebab COVID punya pasal, definitely memang we need to follow the SOP. Kalau untuk face to face dekat dalam kelas, face, susah nak cakap sekarang ni, because kalau term face to face ni in kementerian, face to face tu kalau live face to face pun dikira face to face. Face to face yang dalam kelas, face to face dalam kelas, yang space tu you need to ada jarak lah. So I try to design U shape. Okay, U shape. Lagi example U shape macam ni. Tunjukkan contoh U shape. So design class yang I suggest something U shape. Okay, meja. Okay, meja. U shape. So this is our projector. Okay, nampak tak? Boleh nampak. Okay, so this is the lecturer. Kalau I zoom sikit. Okay, tu tak. Oh, tu unzoom, sorry. Okay, so your camera, I will suggest you put here in the middle. Sini, camera. I tak suggest you put at the back. Because you just imagine kalau I kata student yang online tu, bayangkan lima, okay, kalau offline yang ada face to face ni, dia ada duduk depan, tengah, belakang. Belakang, belakang, tengah, depan. Okay, dia punya feeling different Who sit in front and who sit at the back. But kan kita kata 50-50 kan, student datang kan. Kalau just imagine kalau dalam kelas kita ada 50 student, 25 student dekat dalam kelas, 25 lagi dekat online. Just imagine kalau you letak dekat belakang, lagi 25 orang student tu dia rasa dia duduk belakang. That's why we need to set up the camera tu memang betul-betul dia duduk dekat in front, so that at least first kita boleh minimumkan cost wiring panjang-panjang ke belakang. And then dia lagi dekat dengan kita, and then sebab dia at the middle ni, so we can walk around, so dia akan nampak lah. Okay, and then kita boleh interact with our face to face audience. Dengan yang online pun sometimes we look at the camera macam dalam TV lah. Kalau you can if you have had experience in recording in TV station, you akan nampak kamera tu, dia akan follow you, ada kamera lampu merah kan, dia follow you, so that's the experience lah. Okay, so space technology remain memang teknologi lah, at least what I mentioned, one camera, but if you can have second camera tu much better lah. Give example, right now kalau you tengok in Zoom, you nampak my face one camera and the other one yang wide camera. So it depend on your student, either they want to see or they want to watch you yang memang focus more to your face, or dia nak tengok yang wide. Okay, so ni memang minimum cost. That camera tu cost, oh itu camera Logitech, RM400 lah. So yang ini something 800 something. Okay, so that is how it works, my philosophy. And this space ni ada offline and online. Okay, and then I love to use this diagram lah for space. Space ni, this just academic macam knowledge lah about space. We need to focus on physical need and emotional need. Okay, this is just a theory, but it good. But maybe after this, if you need this slide, I will share with Dr. Yazid, and then maybe Dr. Yazid can distribute to all. Okay, online engagement. When we talk about online engagement, we need to choose at least one software, either Teams, Meet, Zoom, Webex, or whatever we want to use in our class lah. But I will suggest you to use whatever UM already provided to us, either Teams or Meet. Okay, that is my suggestion. But I will, if you ask me, I will go for Teams. Why? Because Teams, we can have a different function, the chat and the activity, macam dah social, the notification tu kan, we can use that function lah. And the best part about Teams, when your student record that session, semua dapat. But kalau Meet, you record, you dapat seorang-seorang, and then you kena bagi pada your student. So I not encourage that lah. And then in your class tu, I will suggest you to record your session. Just record. Okay, record. Okay, why? Okay, sekarang ni we have our online student and offline student, face to face or offline face to face student. You just imagine if I ask my student either they want to meet offline or online right now lah, since 2 days back when I ask them, they really want to go to face-to-face class. Okay, most of them lah, not all, but most of them, because I don't have any problem that student don't want to come for now. For now, after this I have no idea, but when I asked them two days ago, I think I have another challenge to choose who, because 70% want to join offline class. That's my challenge. Okay, why? Because when I explain to them, yeah, if you come to my class, you will get this exclusive session with me directly, because at the same time that session will be recorded. If you want to watch that recorded, you can watch lah after this. But if you are online student, you memang tengok online, record pun lebih kurang sama. So you just get macam you dapat satu package lah. You will get just only one package yang online tu je lah. So yang offline, dia dapat two package. Dia dapat jumpa offline and online. So we try to give that kind of awareness to our student lah, but make sure lah SOP semua we try to follow lah. Okay, Yang tentang COVID, I tak nak cerita because dia complicated. Complicated ni means ada orang kata sekarang ni tak selesa, tak selamat lagi. Okay, it depends eh. It depends. For me, I try my best to engage with my student. Okay, settle. Engage as much as I can, I can lah. Eh, during that session. Okay. So this is online ni. And then when I design my session, I always use this figure tau. This figure that means I have the first yang offline, online, atas tu face to face. I face to face ni whether you meet them face to face yang offline, jumpa eh face to face offline or face to face online, they still consider face to face. Kalau in Kementerian Pendidikan punya term lah, okay. But we need to understand face to face yang gunakan medium ni, dia punya problem dia, bukan problem lah, dia punya challenge dia, your punya hardware. You need to make sure your hardware function and can be used during that session. I give you example. I come to class and then I start my session. I think I dah set up my devices ni. Bagi contoh lah. Rupa-rupanya I mute, lepas tu I didn't connect to my microphone. So my online student didn't get that session lah. They can't learn lah because dia tak dengar my voice. Okay, so when you come into your class, better you take 5 to 10 minutes to make sure the setting is yalah already okay, and then you just maybe mingle around with your student, your online student. You can hear my voice ke, and then okay ke, macam itulah. You just test, kan? Sometimes your device okay, but internet okay, like mine. Right now tadi internet tak okay, so I need to get another internet. Okay, so that's the challenge lah. Okay, so the e-learning, just e-learning for the synchronized. So yang itu kita ketepikan lah, kita punya spectrum. Okay, spectrum, you need to make sure you set the proper instruction, because our spectrum will be the landing page for our student. Landing page mean student ni dia nak pergi kelas ni next week, and then dia dengar khabar angin kata, oh, the lecturer kata kelas kita ni hybrid. Dia dengar cerita kan, and then maybe they didn't have our phone number, so they go to spectrum. But in spectrum there's no announcement. So we need to put some announcement in there, bagi instruction, like what I've done. Macam I put instruction in spectrum, and then my student, when they read the instruction, because I ask them to go to another platform, Facebook group, because I want to give instruction live video, or you can pre-recorded your video and put in spectrum. Okay, I show you example. Okay, show you example my spectrum, just a simple one. Spectrum. Okay, this is my spectrum. Hopefully you can see. What is it? Huh? This is spectrum exam. Okay, sorry. Kan dah buat exam, belum start lagi semester eh. Dah buat exam pula. Okay, kita buat sekejap spectrum dulu. Okay, this is my spectrum. Okay, spectrum. I give you one example. Maybe this class. Okay. In announcement, I share a few announcement. So first step, what? Please join our Facebook group. Blah blah blah. I give the link so the student join that group. And another one, I ask them to go and update or join the Teams lah, because I will be using Teams. Okay. So because I have a live session with them before, I think on this Saturday I have a online session with them, because I want to explain the final list lah, student who yang can join my face to face class kan. Okay, so they join and then they go to Facebook. Okay, so that is my setting, because I want to, at least I try to engage with them first. Okay, first ni tak masuk kelas lagi, first set up tu dulu. I set up all of that element, how to engage with them first. Okay, yang tadi tu I PIB 4012. Okay, ni dia. Okay. Okay, so dia dah ada, okay, ada 7 member request. So dia request lah. So kita tengok student ni, memang ni lah semua student ni contohnya. Okay, Ria, kita approve dia masuk. Hero, Haris, okay. So after that, then I can live in this and then I explain to them lah. Okay, so that is how first step before I go to class, okay, next week. Okay, so back to this, okay, YouTube is YouTube lah. YouTube, because most of the student punya assignment, I will ask them to put in their channel. Okay, settle. Tak apa, kita terus je. Kita tak nak cerita ni kan. So, Facebook group tadi dah settle. And then, okay, the learning space. Okay. Learning space. Okay, our class. Actually, we need to design our class to sampai dia jadi bukan kelas mata-mata, because our class tu memang need to become something yang we call it as a learning space, or bukan mata-mata kelas. Memang kelas tu learning space, but learning space something that term that we really encourage them to learn something new, and then not only learn, when they learn something, they share something so that everybody can learn, okay? Learn new things, okay? So this is just a example, just mock up in our setting in our faculty. So the setup, okay? This is the setup. First, the basic setup. Basic setup, like I said earlier, at least you have one webcam and one microphone. At least one microphone. Please don't use your laptop microphone, because sometimes the quality is too it's not so good lah. Itu je lah nak cakap. I tak boleh cakap, because lain laptop, lain dia punya microphone kan. But I will encourage you, at least you have dedicated microphone. Dedicated microphone ni, I suggest at least Boya lah. Boya. B-O-Y-A. Boya. Boya. Dia wired. Dia memang berapa meter tu memang, I think waktu sebelum, before I use this wireless, I memang pakai Boya. The quality is good. Dia, and then dia boleh cancel some noise. Actually, this setting is not suitable because before this ada beberapa kain langsir tau. So dia tak ada bergema macam ni. Tapi dah lama tak ni kita cuci. So dia tak ada kain ni, dia bergema lah ni. So but when we use the quality microphone, they try to minimize the echo. Echo still ada ni. Ni kalau kalau siapa datang sini, you boleh dengar echo ni sangat kuat. But in online, dia dah try to minimize. Still ada, but dia try to minimize. Okay. Okay, so we go to that setting back there. Okay. Okay, so this setting, this memang betul-betul I try to apa, betul-betul sebiji macam lebih kurang laptop faculty lah. Try, I turunkan sikit. Ini tripod yang tinggi sangat. So this setup eh. Okay. Okay, kita wet sikit. Okay. So first you come into your class. Kalau our faculty dah set up the camera, then make sure the camera already connected with your PC. Itu normal lah, itu normal, because I think before this, kalau sound tak ada pun kita panggil technician kan, some of our friends lah. So I think right now kalau tak ada sound, kita dah boleh try and error lah. But after this, memang kadang-kadang this camera they have a conflict with the PC, so we really need to call our technician. That's why our technician pun nak entertain yang lain. Jadi we try our best untuk try to I call it kita try to settle sendirilah. The webcam is easy for me lah. Webcam is easy if dia tak keluar apa-apa, you plug, you try to take off the USB and then plug in again, or you restart lah computer. Okay, so that is the default webcam. That's why I said webcam, because kalau SLR dia different dia punya setting. So, different setting dia. Okay, webcam eh, webcam dia maksudnya you plug in dia terus keluar. Normally dia memang boleh keluar macam tu. Okay, so kita punya conflict right now when dia shoot slide. Sekarang ni kalau default punya setting when our projector show our slide ni, okay, slide, okay, and then our student yang online student tu adalah kat tepi tu, okay, on that side. Okay, so this setting just use one monitor je. Okay, so you can set up something. This is the default one lah. Okay, on macam you buat online class last year, but you need to place the camera in the middle yang betul-betul dekat dengan you punya station lah, workstation tu means if your laptop in front of your class macam ni, I set a separate different setting in front there, then you need to make sure this camera ni memang you can interact with your online student. Okay, so that's the basic one, basic. Okay, so any question about the basic setting first?
Okay, mungkin saya boleh tanya satu soalan. Kalau kita basic setting ni, macam mana nak effectively interact dengan our online student?
Okay, siapa nak interact? Student ke lecturer?
Lecturer dulu.
Okay, lecturer nak interact with siapa? Student online ke offline?
Online student.
Online student?
Aha.
Normally memang nak interact with online student eh? Nak nak interact, kita same like offline lah. We try to ask question lah. Question ke, or we try to create macam
kita sebenarnya akan cakap dengan kamera lah kan?
Macam mana?
Kita sebenarnya akan bercakap depan kamera lah kan?
Depan kamera lah. Because that camera tu ialah student. Yang design tu is up to us lah. Either we create macam online tu ada satu group student online lawan dengan student offline. Bukan lawan lah, maksudnya okay, siapa tanya soalan ke kan? Or kita, we ask them question ke. I tak encourage kita, I didn't encourage we ask our student to switch on dia punya kamera. Bukan, salah. I salah. I didn't ask them to switch on their camera tau. But I encourage them to switch on their camera indirectly. Indirectly means macam kita katalah, okay, kalau dapat tengok muka tu lagi happy, nampak sama-sama, you nampak kawan-kawan, macam tu lah. Kan, nampak muka, ni, kita give them something like, macam memorable punya moment lah. So, normally, kalau dia betul-betul feel, they want to be with us, dia akan try to switch on dia punya kamera lah. Normally macam tu lah. But we need to get dia punya trust dululah. Tapi kita tak boleh paksa dia switch on kamera sebenarnya, sebab kalau tak silap ada rules Google kan, something macam itulah. Tapi it depends lah, you punya style of setting your classroom macam mana kan. Ada lecturer memang paksa student switch on kamera, but for me I didn't, macam I tak paksa lah. I just encourage them to switch on. And at the same time, try ask them to engage lah. Tanya soalan. Itulah. Okay? Okay, any more question? Yang default dulu.
Ini ada soalan daripada Suhana. Dr. Suhana. What kind of mic Dr. Syari use currently? Is it wired boya or wireless mic?
Okay. Okay. Either wired or wireless. Macam ni eh. If you have more budget lah, go for wireless. Tapi I tak kata terus beli wireless sekarang, sebab you need to macam mana? Okay, macam ni. Before this, face to face class kan. Kita masuk kelas, kita mengajar macam tak ada apa-apa pun. Kita kena bawa, kita kena pegang, kita kena handle. There's nothing yang kita kena uruskan dekat badan kita tau. Nothing. Kalau kita masuk dekat stesen TV pun sometimes kan, the microphone, we didn't set ourselves. Ada orang yang tolong pasangkan semua tau. Okay? But when we talk about today's punya situation ni, sometimes kan, nak pasang dekat sini pun kita terlupa, kita tak aware. And then sometimes, bila wireless eh, dia punya receiver ni tertinggal dah, tak boleh nak guna dah. So, I suggest beli wired dulu. Beli wired, you try dulu with those wired. Memang leceh sebab dia banyak wire lah, but at least you have little bit idea lah how to manage things lah. And then ada satu some point nanti kan, you akan rasa macam, oh tak boleh ni, kena pakai wireless. Okay, nak pakai wireless, you can use the radio wave ni wireless. And then right now I think dia ada yang the cheapest one, ada yang 100 lebih, 200 lebih tu, the wireless lah. Still okay sebenarnya. Okay, yang wireless. Tapi wireless ni, when come wireless, dia ada dua benda nak kena jaga. Satu, receiver ni. Ya, tengok apa tak. Receiver. Tak jumpa. Okay, tak jumpa. Okay. Ni lah, nampak tak? Alamak, ni tengah pasang dekat I punya laptop. Ni receiver. Receiver ni yang selalu tertinggal. Tahu? Because kita guna PC faculty. Kalau kita guna PC kita tak apa, tak ada masalah. Kita memang akan bungkus sendiri. But sometimes bila kita punya pen drive pun kadang-kadang kita pakai tu kita tinggal. So kat situlah kita kena be careful lah. Okay, tapi first I will suggest you to we try dulu pakai wired tu murah je, 30 lebih kan. Then after that baru kita akan tahu. Sometimes my friends in ada one of my friends dia pakai wired after I suggest him, because dia nak beli macam I ni wireless. This wireless ni RM800. I tak suggest dia because I use this for recording in studio. So apa tu? Oh, and ada question. How do you set the screen to be able to show the student when you share your screen? Usually after sharing, we can only the slide. Okay. Okay. Sekali lagi. Okay. This is at the back ni is the basic setting. Basic setting tu one monitor. So when you share your screen, definitely you cannot see your student lah, because dia akan appear your slide. What you can see in the screen right now is not that screen. This is my screen. This is the other. The okay, we name it lah. To A setting, set A, set B, set B view ni. Ni set B view because I'm using this setting to share the slide. Okay, the other part tu just a student punya view. Student can see that kind of view. Okay, so if you ask me how I can see my student and at the same time my slide, definitely you need to have two monitor or you need to to make it. Ni all lah, all. Kalau you ada satu monitor je, you need to make it your presentation tu smaller lah.
Lazada dan sedia.
What is this? Lazada?
Ini
Boya wireless ni kan? Ni baik Boya wireless macam ni. Ni ya, Boya wireless. This is Boya wireless. Boya wireless.
Jangan,
okay, Boya wireless ni I tak encourage beli sebab dia besar. Tahu dia besar. You nak letak macam mana? Letak macam dekat TV tu. Memang lagi dia besar. I tak encourage. I pun tak guna. Okay, I pun tak guna. I ada tapi I tak guna. I tak encourage lah Boya wireless ni. And then satu lagi dia gunakan bateri. Dia guna bateri tau. Okay.
Kita ada seorang partisipan, Dr. Yohanis nak tanya soalan.
Okay, sila.
Okay, sorry. Assalamualaikum and gaming everyone. Okay, the thing is that it's good that you all have all the setup and all that kan? But then for, let's say in CSS, everything is not ready, you know, and then we also don't have like a plan to rotate student, and apparently it looks like that everybody's gonna come in and then we're gonna use all the DKA and the Makmal or whatever not. So we don't have the setup like this, But I was just thinking that can we just use like whatever whenever we're doing the what you call it the online course? I mean, like when we do virtual classes and all that. When you connect to the HDMI to the what you call it the projector,
yeah.
Does the projector has it role as another display, or is it just going to transmit whatever that's on your laptop? Because the thing is that in some computer, if you go to the setup and they show the display, and you get the projector will be displayed too.
Yep.
So, and then maybe when you show something online and you want them to interact, then probably you can put display too as where the student, like what we're having right now, like I'm using two monitor. One monitor will show the PowerPoint and all that, and the other monitor is just showing the participants. So I'm just thinking whether the projector has that capacity to play the role at a second display. Because to be honest, we don't have anything here. So the only thing that we can do, like I said, that some lecturers are not happy about it because you have to bring your own laptop. And you have to connect to the projector, and because everything is juristic here, even the in the lecture hall, the computer is also outdated again. So if it's heavy, that could hang and everything. So probably you have to bring your own laptop. So can it be done or not? I mean, that's the only way that I can see like, how you can attend to the online and offline simultaneously.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you. For that question, actually, it depends on the computer. Either the computer have the graphic card. Normally, the default one, they just clone whatever output on our monitor. Though they just output to the projector. Okay. But if the computer PC in the class, if the PC in that class have maybe a good graphic card, then it can extend the output lah into the extended version lah. Maksudnya dia extend this is another screen one. And in at the PC tu punya monitor screen tu, it can be done actually. But it depend on the PC. Because kita punya PC in UM ni tak sama kan dia punya spec. But in my faculty, it cannot extend the output lah. Whatever yang appear on the monitor screen, it's the same will be appear on the projector. But if you use your own laptop, that is another case lah. If you use your laptop, then you can normally laptop nowadays punya laptop it can extend the screen. Okay. So that will be my answer because I cannot answer directly because it depend on the computer in the graphic card in the PC lah. Normally macam tu lah.
Okay, thank you. So I guess you just have to do with whatever we have lah.
Yeah, normally memang we just assume. That's why when I discuss with Dr. Yazid, I kata we need to assume we only have one output monitor je. One output monitor je. At least we have one output monitor, okay lah, kan? Our monitor pun keluar A, and then projector pun keluar A, okay? Then we play around with whatever we had je lah, tu je lah. So, but the intermediate tu, that's why intermediate for those who the lecturer who want to bring their own laptop, then that is another case lah. So right now the basic one, I think most of us we have that setting, the default setting in our faculty. I think at least we have that kind of setting lah. One monitor, kalau sekarang ni dah tak ada one camera, maybe ada, kalau ada microphone, mesti kena ada microphone eh. Kalau tak ada microphone, still online student takkan dengar sangat suara kita. Unless kelas kecil lah kan, still we can use apa namanya microphone in our apa integrated microphone in webcam. Dalam webcam tu sometimes dia ada microphone kan. Itu je lah jawapan yang I boleh share. Setting, the basic setting memang macam tu. At least we start lah. We tak apalah, kita start lah. Memang that is the paling minimum. Before this, maybe kita tak ada kamera. Tak ada kamera tau. Tak ada kamera. Kalau ada kamera, much better. Kalau tak ada kamera, kalau faculty yang tak ada kamera tu, dia complicated sikit lah. Bukan complicated, dia different sikit lah. Because you want to how to show our face kan. Dalam kelas student tak nampak. I hope ada kamera. At least ada kamera. And then ada additional yang basic ni, kamera and microphone. At least. Itu je lah. At least kalau ada tu, at least kita dah boleh at least proper sikit lah untuk yang basic ni. Kalau tak ada tu memang agak little bit memang susah sikit lah. Okay, any more question? Thank you tadi. Thank you lagi. Does online student hear the interaction in the class with the offline student? Okay, we talk. Okay, this is basic though. Basic. Okay. Macam ni. We have, I give example, 1 hour lecture. First, the pedagogy, we need to understand how many percent we will use our voice to engage with our student. I give example, maybe 60-70% maybe. And then when our student, this is the basic setting, basic setting. When the student they want to answer question ke, we need to pass the microphone to them lah, or at least we stand near to them ke kan, at least the audio is there lah, the microphone will capture the audio, so at least that's the minimum setting that we can use lah. Okay, why? Okay, dia macam ni, when we talk about microphone, dia ada banyak jenis, there are a lot of type of microphone. If we use the microphone, the built-in microphone in our webcam, then it will the microphone dia punya behavior, it will try to capture all sound around them. Sama. That means kalau student bercakap semua dengar, and then kalau I explain pun lebih kurang sama. That's why the microphone tu kita letak dekat lecturer. So because the lecturer is our center yang engage with the student, we try to make sure when we engage with our student tu, we need to make sure lah bila student tu nak bercakap, then we try lah give the microphone, but bukan bagilah, bukan bagi dia pegang lah, just macam we play around lah with the microphone, so that it will capture the student punya audio. So itu je yang boleh, paling minimum kita boleh buat. I tak encourage you guys to give the microphone to the student, so student akan pegang, because kita tak tahu student kita ni background dia macam mana, dia jumpa, dia duduk dekat dalam bas, macam-macam kan. So be careful, jangan bagi student pegang your microphone, okay? Because we try our best untuk tak jadi agent lah, penyebar benda-benda ni. Kita jumpa ramai student kan, so that's why we need to take care ourselves first. That's why first I will encourage to buat U-shape ni. That means U-shape ni you memang akan jauh dengan student. Bukan jauh-jauh apa, you akan directly jauh lah. Kalau when we compare tu yang setting yang nampak banyak orang buat tu, dia you akan rapat dengan student lah. So that's my what I can share lah about that setting. Okay. Issue university needs to solve before continue hybrid teaching. But this is microphone. Yeah. because about microphone, when I share with faculty pendidikan, my faculty, actually I also didn't realize about that until Associate Professor Dr. Visha raised that issue. Then I noticed that I forgot about the microphone, because I suggest to faculty to buy the Boya microphone because it macam murah, paling murah yang boleh kan. Kan? And then at least they can capture the voice. But when Dr. Visha mentioned, okay, kalau macam the saliva lah kena tu, and then orang lain, oh, so dia dah jadi issue, another issue. So my suggestion for that, okay, my suggestion my suggestion, kalau betul-betul you want to explore in that element, I would suggest faculty to buy this one. Extender. This is extender. Okay, extender. So, okay, extender. Macam ni, extender, okay. One part, you plug in into the audio, and the other part dia kosong. So you lecturer, you just bring your own microphone, and then you cucuk lah, and then you buka. And then another lecturer pun masuk, you cucuk. Yang ini you masuk ke PC lah, okay? So kalau nak, itu antara solution lah. Suggestion, that's my suggestion, because ini extender ni memang ada jual juga, extender, the audio extender. Okay, so yeah, microphone is, but please, apa saja setting, please jangan bagi student pegang. That's because before this ada yang suggest, okay, the camera we can ask the pedagogy part kan, we can ask the student to handle the camera, and then the student will will help us in class. Jangan macam tu. Biar jangan.
Dr. Syaril, ada satu soalan. Yep. How about we utilize the student's device, but the problem maybe ada echo lah, because each of them have their own mobile phone.
Student
kan?
Device.
Yeah, student device.
Student punya
mobile
device.
Mobile phone dia. Untuk.
Apa boleh. Boleh, tak masalah.
But need to be careful lah, because when they turn on, when two devices present at the same room, they will be echo lah.
Echo lah. So that's the thing lah. Echo tu actually kena pada yang online student tu nanti. Because before this, I memang encourage my student before this 2017-16, I encourage all my student to record my session during my class tau. Memang I suruh, okay, siapa nak record. So memang ada student yang tak datang kelas. So dia tak datang kelas, dia tengok yang dalam sesi tu tau, dia buat live. Most of my student ada Facebook group. Okay, ni I share sikit lah why I choose Facebook group. Because nanti kalau kita nak buat curriculum review, senang. Mereka dah jadi alumni, kita boleh terus tanya soalan in each of that group. So itu dia punya agendanya lah. Bila curriculum review nak dapatkan alumni punya respon, senang. Okay, so that's why I set a few Facebook group lah, dedicated betul-betul in each of my classes tu. So dalam that group tu, tu secret group tau. That means semua yang ada dalam tu je boleh tengok. So sometimes dia buka, dia orang pasang sendiri je, because dia kata nanti dia nak tengok semula kan. Okay, never mind, you record lah. Kita bukan nak cakap benda tak elok pun, kita cakap benda-benda yang pasal belajar kan. So that's the philosophy tau. I tahu ada lecturer didn't encourage to do that, but for me, I've nothing to hide. Macam itulah. And then all my student memang dia record, and then they help others yang tak dapat datang to learn. And then at the same time, dia dapat the second chance to join that class again. Dia tengok semula the rakaman, the recording session tu kan. So yeah, you can use that kind of thing. Tau, that means you mengajar in your class and you encourage your student to record that session in mana tu, you kena declare in which platform. Because if you have proper platform, macam I give you example Facebook lah, Facebook group, in Facebook group we have banyak function, one of it live session, live ah, live. So live. Eh? Kalau IG, I tak encourage because IG kalau live satu dunia boleh tengok. Kawan-kawan dia. Facebook group. Facebook personal lain, Facebook group lain, Facebook page lain eh. But I mention here Facebook group. Eh, Facebook group. Tu je ada. So dia memang you can set up like that. They still hybrid. Because ada online and then maybe they want to ask question, the student who recorded that video tu dia boleh macam bantu lah. So that is relate to the pedagogy. You buat pair what you call it, pair something lah, pair apalah, pair one offline satu online kan, pair but tu student punya device lah. You try lah to encourage them kalau kita tak ada set up something like this. At least lah macam tu lah. Can? Okay? Any more? There will be a lot of echo. Yeah. Other solution is to use conference mic. Okay. Conference mic, yes. Itu, that's the ultimate solution lah. Tapi you tahulah conference mic tu macam mana. Conference mic tu sometimes set up nak kena bawa, itu benda yang memang lagi hustle lah, lagi banyak hustle lah. Yeah, itu solution yang paling best lah. Okay, any more question before we move to the yang intermediate ni? Because intermediate I want to change the projector into this laptop. Okay, ada lagi? Tak ada. Boya, yes boya. Sekali lagi wireless boya, I tak encourage you to buy wireless boya because wireless boya tu dia terlalu banyak sangat dia punya. I tak encourage what I suggest you the wired boya, wired dia cost 30 40 something je. Okay, kalau nak belilah. Any suggestion affordable good quality conference mic? Okay. Yang ini kalau I nak suggest apa brand apa tu, I forgot to ni, later I share you the link lah. This is my number, then I will share the link lah because I forgot the green brand lah. Normally yang low cost ni I suggest Boya lah because the Boya the quality, the wave, because I'm looking at the way sometimes I want to edit the audio kan, because we compare several microphone yang murah-murah ni tau, bukan microphone yang lagi murah ni lah, yang ni RM3 je, ini RM3 je, still okay for backup lah kan, okay lah RM3 kan, yang kan, tapi still at least dia dedicated microphone lah. Yang RM3 ni yang tak bestnya, once jatuh dia rosak terus, itu je lah. Okay, Lazada apa ni? Zoom Boya. Uy, ini kau agak-agak. Okay, boleh lah juga. Kan, boleh juga ini. Tapi, okay tau. Yang ini pun okay, you can use this. Ni bulky sikit lah. Bulky sikit means, bulky lah. Macam tu je lah. I nak cakap. Sebab, you try to feel macam you theoretically kita boleh buat apa saja tools yang kita nak guna macam ni lah, kita imagine, but the most important thing kita betul-betul we need to feel it from our room, kita nak pergi ke kelas, we bring those technology tu, kalau itu kita punya lah, kalau in faculty tu we still need to feel from our room, pergi ke kelas, and then how to set up, then baru kita tahu apa lagi kita nak improve. That feeling tu sebenarnya kena rasa betul-betul. Bukannya kita agak-agak tak boleh, dia kena rasa betul-betul. Sometimes macam I share with my technician lah, I cakap, from my room to my class, nearly berapa, I tu kira 100 berapa langkah, I langkah, pergi sana, and then I need to make sure how many minutes I jalan sampai set up. If I don't want to bring my device. I make sure, macam itulah I cakap with the technician lah. So dia punya feeling tu kita tak nak. Kita datang and then barang tak boleh guna. Barang tak boleh guna because we cannot interact with online student. Tapi this offline student dah datang dah. So how, that's why the setup need to be in order betul-betul lah. Either we come in earlier ke kan. Yeah. Because di konflik dia macam tu tau. You nak setup tak settle-settle ni. Sedangkan sebenarnya you dah tak boleh mengajar lah. Sebab student online offline dah ada. But you need to yalah, make sure lah the devices in order. That's why for those who want to bring their own laptop, dia macam ada privilege sikit lah. Privilege sikit means they use their own, dia come out dekat dalam kelas, semua dah ada dekat laptop dia. So that's why I name it as, okay, that we call it as an intermediate. At least dia dah control several things lah yang they can't control if anything happen to the PC in the classroom. Macam itulah. Okay. Any more question? Dah tak ada? I nak buka tu sana. Ni apa ni? But this Boya BMM 400 ni okay sebenarnya. Okay. And it depend on your setting tau. That's why I encourage you guys kalau dapat setting U-shape ni. And then U-shape ni kalau ada student lagi, you letaklah belakang ni kan. Belakang ni. U-shape. They still U-shape. So your microphone tu you boleh letak tengah-tengah. Macam conference lah. Like a conference. Okay? Like conference. So, just imagine if you set up like this, you make sure your student memang facing ke sini. Dia facing sini tau. So kalau you put the microphone, the microphone there, dia much practical lah. Macam itulah. That's the setting that we need to betul-betul aware lah. The human factor tadi tu betul-betul kita kena align with the technology, with ours technology yang ada lah. Kalau kita banyak duit kita boleh je pasang banyak-banyak yang microphone tu kan. Okay, yang itu I raise my case lah. Itu memang you buat banyak-banyak microphone tu tak payah pakai disiplin apa-apa pun, semua dah ada. Okay, settle. Cakap mana-mana pun semua dengar. Settle. Okay? But right now,
Syaril, yep. Ada satu lagi. How about speaker?
Okay.
Speaker to listen to the student online.
Okay.
Speaker.
Student online. Speaker.
Okay. Where is the best place to place it?
Okay. Ni pun it depend on your sound card tau. But my suggestion, dia punya setting better. Mana ada ada speaker tak sekejap I try to. Okay. Better the speaker kan. Okay, just imagine lah, this is speaker this speaker, and then you are facing your student right now. Make sure this speaker, please put this speaker in front of you. No, bukan dekat belakang. Why belakang ni? Because kalau belakang, ini depend on your sound card. You cakap, dia keluar dekat you punya PC. And then dia keluar dekat sini. And then bila dia keluar sini, dia masuk balik semula dekat microphone you. That's why echo the conflict. The conflict yang bunyi macam itu sebab dia conflict. Because the input output dia masuk serentak. Okay, I cakap dia keluar dekat speaker. Tapi apa yang dekat keluar speaker tu dia masuk semula dekat microphone I. So dia akan jadi echo, dia jadi conflict. Itu yang dia bunyi yang bunyi macam kadang-kadang bunyi ting 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 yang dia besar. So conflict tu lah. Because the placing of the speaker. So my suggestion, normally I will put speaker memang in front of me. Tapi my setting ni, my sound card kuat okay. So I letak microphone mana-mana okay. Tapi kalau default punya setting, better the microphone, the speaker in front lah. Or memang speaker yang memang mahal tu lah. Speaker mahal tu normally dia memang 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 speaker mahal and microphone yang proper, dia akan try to eliminate the noise, dia akan try to eliminate the same wave akan masuk semula. Tahu. So kita tak nak cakap lah yang lebih detail tu. Dia punya solution, try to put your speaker in front of you. Sebab itulah kalau kita perasan kan, selalunya kalau dekat PC, speaker tu ada dekat depan, dekat depan kita, dekat depan kita. Tahu. Itu kalau, sekali lagi disclaimer depend on your sound card. Tahu. Tapi kalau sound card yang better, okay, better use wireless. Okay, yang itu kalau you ada, much better lah. Settle lah. You ada. You terus dengar terus. Tapi yang tak best ni, student lain tak dengar lah. Dia ada student tak dengar lah. Tapi depend on your punya setting tau. Because if your setting memang you don't want your student to hear. Bukan, kalau kita itu yang kita ada setting tu, kita pakai at least kita boleh dengar lah. We can hear the question from the online student. Okay. What you using voice meter? Voice meter. What do you mean by voice meter? Hai, tengok jap. Voice meter ni apa? Voice meter.
I think it is a software integrated inside your computer. That allows us to do configuration on sound card kot.
Okay, yang itu mungkin boleh lah, configure lah. But yang itu we need to ask our technician lah. Because sekarang ni kita fokus pada yang, kalau yang basic tadi, fokus pada computer classroom kan. So yang itu maybe kita boleh adjust lah. Actually boleh adjust sebenarnya. Tapi dia banyak kerja lah. Banyak kerja lah nak kena adjust. That's why kalau if we use our own devices, memang dia kurang sikit lah konfliknya. Ini ada ni, okay ni, BB audio software, okay. Okay. So, and then one more thing kenapa I tak suggest, I kata I tak suggest yang microphone yang built-in, yang boleh record semua tu, dia ada kaitan dengan copyright issue. Okay, macam ni. Contohnya macam ni. If we really want to record our session, our classroom, our teaching and learning punya session, and then we want to put in maybe kat mana-mana lah, online, especially I give example macam dekat YouTube. So we need to make sure the copyright issue tu kita try to eliminate tau. Okay, kat mana copyright issue akan jadi? Just imagine that microphone dia record surrounding, and then one of our student dia terlupa nak mute dia punya handphone, and then dia keluar ringtone dia Justin Bieber punya lagu. That lagu tu memang ada copyright. So memang ada a few minutes kat situ adalah copyright kita kena. Tak banyak lah, tapi ada lah, tapi tak cantik lah. That's why we try to, memang the SOP tu memang kena proper lah. Make sure you punya phone kena mute dalam kelas kan. Please don't use apa-apalah yang audio yang memang yang boleh copyright, because once you record that video, because macam right now sekarang ni pun dengar. Ini lagu copyright, baru cakap. Okay, so that is just example, memang cantik example tu datang. Okay, so that's one thing. And then right now pun algoritm dalam Facebook pun dia dah detect banyak copyright, because a few days back I ada buat lah something dekat dalam Facebook, and then dia detect tu, and then dia bagi notification to, dah dia bagi notification kena copyright, and then I kena ada something lah, I kena lah. So kita need to be careful lah, tu je lah. Tapi kalau for those who don't want to put mana-mana, dia tak ada isu banyak lah. Tapi I kata rugi lah, because that video actually we can come up with our own video module tau. Video module means macam, okay, this semester we record 14 weeks punya kuliah. Next next year we still teach that that course. We can use that 14 week the previous years tu untuk sebagai bahan bantu mengajar untuk student analyze ke, tengok dulu ke, and then we can improvise our field. Macam itulah konsep dia. Konsep dia because I memang encourage since the beginning I join education, I encourage semua untuk record. At least we can see lah how to improve because ada record video. Because sometimes kita tersalah cakap kan, tersalah ke, and then student dia tengok dia boleh tolong bantu betulkan ke, something yang itulah. Sometimes macam itulah. Kita human being. Okay. So okay, I think dah settle. I nak terus voice meter tu technical. Ya, memang technical. Tu technical. I tak itu memang mungkin better kalau edek nanti boleh buat satu session lain lah. Okay, ada YouTube banyak tools and software. Yeah, memang betul tools, betul Prof Victor. Okay, banyak tahu tools and software. Okay, so I nak buka sekejap. Okay, kita move to yang bawa laptop lah. Kita tengok setting yang sama. Sekarang ni I present apa yang ni boleh nampak. Share. Ada tak? Kalau share ni nampak tak?
Nampak.
Nampak tak?
Nampak.
Ada nampak. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay, dah nampak. Sorry . Tadi macam ingatkan dah buat dah. Okay. So, yang right now ni, I dah setkan whatever yang ada dekat monitor, dekat laptop monitor, dia keluar dekat PC. Sama macam yang basic one tadi. Uh-huh. Tapi, in our laptop, we can change the option, output, we can share the extended desktop lah. Extended, that means macam ni one output and the other one tu another output. Dia dah jadi macam monitor tu dia bagi lebar lah. Dua monitor, different monitor. Okay, so, two different monitor. So kalau I share this one and then macam mana nak bagi orang nampak ada dua monitor sekarang ya? Because right now you nampak satu, masih nampak satu lagi kan? But in camera, sini nampak tak? Dalam kamera nampak kan? Kamera ni dia ada another screen. So when you slide show your presentation, macam ni, I slide show my presentation. Okay, so yang slide show tu dekat depan, but your screen ni maybe you want to set, you want to see your audience ni yang scene yang you tengah nampak sekarang ni, yang you tengah yang share sekarang ni nampak audience kan? Tak salah. Okay, I bagi contoh sekarang ni, I stop sharing dulu, takut dia pening. Okay, I share screen one. Okay, so right now, okay, you nampak, you nampak lah, you nampak tu, I punya slide tu kan, and then, zoom ni tak nampak tapi in my screen sekarang ni, I nampak lah semua nama-nama, and then in, kalau yang student offline nampak tu, dia nampak the slide show. Student offline pun nampak slideshow. Student online dia nampak macam apa yang you nampak sekarang lah. Dia nampak yang apa tu namanya, kan presenter punya view. Presenter punya view lah. Kalau you tak nak, you bagilah dia view yang sama dengan offline. Ya, dia nampak screen besar juga. Okay. At the same time sebenarnya I tengah nampak, kalau boleh tengok, I tengah nampak tengah tengok semua orang ni sekarang ni in my screen sekarang ni here. Kalau I boleh tengok, I gerakkan sekejap, hopefully tak masalah gerak ni. Tu. Dekat screen I tengah nampak semua orang sekarang. But ni screen laptop, I tengah nampak semua. Audience, online audience. But yang slideshow, offline student pun nampak dekat depan. And then at the same time pun offline student, online student pun nampak yang this part lah. And then kalau I nak drag and show to the student, kalau contohnya I kata nak tunjukkan ramai-ramai kawan-kawan tengah online sekarang ni, so I drag dia, drag dia view tu ke depan, ke output, to output, macam ni lah. So ini memang tricky part sikit lah, but you play around dengan output lah. First you need to set in extended punya desktop, extended bukannya clone. Kalau clone dia same with your monitor, extended so that dia akan jadi monitor 1, monitor 2, and then you play around this with the monitor 1 and monitor 2. But this is the setting where you can look at your student and at the same time you can go for you can present your presentation. Okay, so what I want to add is if we can add this camera, I call it as not I call it lah, dia punya name as OBS bot, this one. I use this camera. Okay, I use this camera. Kalau you nampak in my camera tu, this OBS bot, this is the HD version. The best part about this camera, you can give some instruction lah. Okay, instruction. Okay, instruction, zoom in, zoom out. This is zoom in and zoom out. Nampak? Tak jumpa. Okay, zoom in. They zoom in to your face and then okay, and then you can zoom out. Okay, and then you also can ask this camera to freeze. Jangan ikut lagi kan, don't follow your movement lagi, do freeze lah. So I give example macam I explain about this layout tadi. Okay, and then the camera will follow me. I ask this camera to zoom in, then this one, your ni lah, your slide ni lah. So this slide kan, and then maybe you want this camera focus on this board, then you just stay lah. So this stay. So that is something I think we need to think about if you want to buy our maybe next webcam lah. At least we buy with not only the technology, the technology, that gesture tu punya technology. Okay, and then I think earlier this month this OBS board dia come out with the 4K punya quality, much better from this one. Ini zaman-zaman lama dulu I beli, awal-awal dulu kan. Much better the quality, the video quality is very superb lah, lagi cantik lah. Dia mahal sikit lah. But yang ini it cost me RM800, but the most important thing the quality, and I can record this session in HD tu level HD lah, but the 4K tu memang much better lah the quality. Okay, so in this session for intermediate, first I encourage you all to bring your own laptop and then link to the projector. But at the same time when you link to the projector, the default setting dia akan clone je the output. you try and take a look in at your desktop if you can extend the view. Okay, I show again how to do it. Okay, so you go to go to right click graphic option output to this is clone display. Okay, clone display, but we try to set the extended desktop so at least you have two different output. Okay, so you set that up, and then you can at least you can have two different output. That's the minimum setup lah yang we can do right now. Okay, if you have another monitor, it will help you to show whatever yang ada kat luar macam TV lah. Kat luar tu, belakang tu, the output, at the same time, you boleh nampak this output here. Okay. So, itu kalau ada lebih monitor lah. Okay, but at least you have laptop, projector, you can create separate output. Okay. Any question? I tengok question kat chat jap eh. Question, I think can share name model of this camera. Okay, it called as OBS BOT Mini. Tiny. Dia ada two version, HD and 4K tau. O4K. Okay. Tapi yang 4K tu mahal lagi sikit lah. I think go for HD dah cukup untuk sekarang. Okay, how to check my laptop whether it can support extended screen or not. Okay, how to support? First, your graphic card. Secondly, you can go to desktop. Okay. Maybe you can try right click. Okay, before that, you need to connect to the second output first. Kalau you tak connect, dia tak jumpa nanti. Bila dia nak extend tu ke mana? You kena plug into other output monitor ke, projector ke. You dah plug in. Kalau you tak plug in, dia tak jumpa. Dia tak ada nanti. Plug in and then right click, graphic option, output tu. Okay, after you already plug in to your laptop, then dia akan keluar function ni. Kalau ada. If you had that monitor, most laptop can support extended screen. Nowadays punya laptop kalau like macam 2004-5 punya laptop, because I also had a few macam old laptop, dia tak boleh. Graphic card pun tak ada, tak boleh. So kalau yang latest one, normally okay. Normally memang ada. Normally ada, but this function will be appear when you plug in lah hardware to your laptop. Okay. Okay, proper converter tu it depends tau. Converter macam ni, converter. You need to have a few converter lah. I give example macam yang ini. Sometimes macam right now VGA dah tak ada, so. Tapi kita punya projector still use VGA kan, HDMI, VGA, we need to have one this converter. Okay, yang ini dia pergi ke projector sebelah sini, projector, but this one you go to your laptop. Okay, and sometimes you can use this one also can use the VGA and HDMI, USB. This another Dia punya komputer. Okay. At least you, because last time I right now I bring this kind of converter, I bring at least 3 in my bag. Why? Because selalunya kadang kita dah guna, kita output at mana-mana conference kan, we left that, we forgot that converter. So at least I make sure lah I backup lah in my bag, laptop bag. Okay, so please at least you have this one or mini. Dia boleh VGA ni. Why VGA? Because most of our projector still pakai VGA. VGA tu rupa dia macam the VGA tu yang warna biru yang monitor belakang tu kan, yang besar tu. The VGA. Okay. So HDMI tu most of the laptop ada lah. And then satu lagi sekarang ada mini DP DP mini, dia lagi kecil. So at least you have the VGA. And then you need to make sure lah you ada HDMI ni atau tak. Atau sometimes mini we call it mini DP yang dia lagi kecil daripada ni. You tengok tau betul-betul your laptop. Okay, any more question? Most of our facility use VGA. Yes. Most of our facility in UM memang VGA. So kita pakai bawa je lah satu converter tu. Okay, ada lagi lain? So sekali lagi I recall back. If you bring your own laptop, you go into your classroom, you switch on your laptop, you take the projector punya cable, plug into your laptop. First thing, you need to make sure the output is there. Okay, dikeluar. Okay, cantik. You extend monitor 1, monitor 2. And then after that, you set up your microphone. Set up microphone ni, that's why I suggest tadi you use the wired. Wired tu you cocok, dia terus detect lah. Kalau dia wireless ni, you nak kena on sini, you nak kena on sini, tiba-tiba tengok bateri dah tinggal sikit. Nampak ni? Bateri dah tinggal sikit. Macam mana ni bateri dah tinggal sikit? Kan? Sometimes dia quite complicated bila macam ni lah, bateri dah tinggal sikit, then tiba-tiba dia tak boleh guna. So you rugi lah. Kita rugi lah that session. We cannot use the audio because there's no battery. That's why first, I memang suggest kalau betul-betul nak guna mic, please use the wired first. We try to learn step by step lah. And then maybe after 2 weeks, kita dah terror lah using the wired microphone, then we can move to wireless lah. Okay, I still memang encourage wired dulu, step by step. Okay, any more? Okay, tak ada. Any more question? Tak ada Ada tak yang tak jumpa? Okay, and then if you want to buy this OBS Tiny, okay, I give you the link because I will because I already I tak kenal pun dia tu siapa, tapi I dah mention that when I bought this, I mentioned that you, because my friend also want to ask about this. I tak dapat commission apa pun tak ada. Just I really make sure that you buy from the proper person lah. Okay, yang memang boleh tolong jaga apa-apa, bagi discount, because yesterday one of the professor in my faculty, dia mention yang I bagi link tu, dia kata dia bagi discount. So okay lah, dia bagi coupon discount semua tu kan. So that's why I suggest you buy at the proper punya trusted seller lah. Kena cakap trusted seller, please buy from the trusted seller, because ini mahal, 800 kan, 800, and then you need to make sure yang memang properly can be used semua. Okay, so jap I share you the link, because actually I created one YouTube video sebenarnya last time. Okay, and then after that I kata pada this teller, I told him, him ke her pun I tak tahulah. I kata I want to use your link. Because if anybody want to ask where I bought this, I bought from you lah. Because you give me bagus lah service, yang good service. That's why this seller ni kalau dia perform, then I memang I akan suggest lah. Tapi I tak kenal pun dia. Okay, dia tak bagi apa-apa pun pada I. Tapi because I nak semua orang use this technology, explore this technology, and we can share something lah together. Yeah, so this is my YouTube about this OBS bot ni. Because I think I bought this, I create this video last week I tak ingat. After I dah rasa macam okay lah, that's it lah, I dah penat lah nak bagi demo pada orang. Sebab every day I kena demo to my friends to show them actually it's very easy to set up this camera. You buy this camera, you just plug in, and then after that this OBS will try to search you try to search us lah. And then after that then we directly can use the gesture. Okay, so I think they need to discuss with the technical in charge of this. Not your block, Miss Ali need to technician to set up IP. Okay, IP address, yeah, IP address another thing lah. Technician, might as well just to set up APC obtain, yeah. Like my laptop, actually I set up using IP when I plug in the wired internet. But we need to sit down with our technician, because our technician who in charge with the IP, the list of our IP in the faculty, they will know how to set up lah. Okay, because they want any conflict, IP conflict. So at least we can use our laptop, and then we can use wired internet from our classroom lah. Kalau tak, we just use the wireless lah. Wireless internet ni, I no comment sangat lah. But kalau if you can use the wired internet, much better lah. Internetnya more stable lah. Okay. So I think any more question? Tak ada. Syaril, boleh share YouTube demo and list the basic technical stuff. Boleh share YouTube demo. YouTube demo, what do you mean by YouTube demo? Share YouTube demo. YouTube demo ni apa? About YouTube ke ataupun about what? Kalau nak buat YouTube, kena buat satu sesi lain lah. Because YouTube ni pun best juga sebenarnya. Kalau each of us dah start kena ada YouTube, lagi better lah kalau kita ada recorded video. Kalau YouTube lah. Who asked this question? This Lina Hashim boleh tak tengok tanya? What do you mean by YouTube demo? Nak tunjuk YouTube ke apa ni? Kan aku tunjuk YouTube dah jadi kelas YouTube ni kan?
Mungkin YouTube demo on how you set up the tiny bot tu kot.
Oh, nak YouTube demo, nak buat video YouTube demo set up. Actually set up dia
agaknya lah, saya pun tak pasti.
Saya tak faham soalan tu.
I'm asking, saya jawab on behalf.
tapi kalau nak kata set up, okey, nak kata set up macam nak tunjukkan set up. Setup dia, once you buy this, then you macam kita beli external webcam kan, sometimes we buy and then we just plug in to USB, And then dia automatically dia dah terus akan set up. Easy as that. Sebenarnya lah. So boleh tak I tunjukkan jauh sangat tak kamera dia? I try to bring the other side tu. Kalau boleh. Kamera tu mencari-cari. So, jumpa muka. Okay, nak set up, kalau lah boleh buat live kan, buat live, saya tunjuk satu-satu live kan. Yang itu because depend dia dia link to the laptop, so dia quite susah sikit nak gerak-gerak. Saya boleh tarik tak? Susah lagi tak? Okay, kita try Ambil lagi. Okay, kalau boleh tengok. Okay, come. Okay. Okay, nampak. Okay. So, I switch off this camera tu. Okay, I turn off first. Okay. And then, this is the camera. You can take a look at the other camera. Okay, ni eh. Camera, kau tengok ni. Okay. Kita tutup juga. Terang. Okay. This is the camera. Dia just external webcam je, sama je. Okay. And then, dia pakai the C-type. Pasang ni juga rasa. And then, the USB. Okay, and then when I plug in into my USB, ni plug in, cucuk, pop, automatically the camera dia akan loading, and then they look for dia punya host, host tu human lah. Kalau ada, once dia dah jumpa, then we directly can use our gesture. Okay, terus dah boleh guna. Simple as that lah. Simple as that. Dia punya apa? Dia punya setting. Tapi yang ini, okay. Tak keluar.
Dr. Syarif, audio dah hilang.
Sebab bateri dah habis.
Okay.
Itu that the conflict lah, because I use this since I think early morning tadi. I think 7 o'clock I live with my student until right now lah. I charge kejap tadi tengah hari. Tak ada, memang ni nampak bateri habis, tu dah habis, dah tak ada dah. So itu konfliknya with wireless. Once wireless tak ada, tak adalah. Right now I use what? Apa ni? I use laptop punya microphone. Laptop punya microphone.
Cable apa ni? Mic cable unit tadi tak? Mic ni.
That's why at least if you have yang murah-murahnya the cheaper
microphone pun at least okay lah. Yang microphone macam sama-sama belajar tu kan. So if you use this microphone, at least suara tu much better lah. Tapi ini berapa belah ringgit punya microphone je. Simpan lah backup. Tapi wired lah. Ni wired lah ni. Wired. Okay. Okay, I think if there no any more question, I think thank you for your participation and then your patience. Kalau I answer your question, if you want to ask more after this, you can contact me and then I try my best to help lah. To help. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Sorry lah, because this is my first time demo the technical thing tau. Normally I ask semua orang datang tengok, itu lagi senang lah. But this is the first time yang macam I just a little bit headache lah. Before lunch tadi, how to set up lah, to setting. So this is the best that I can share lah. Sorry lah if to macam give you some confusion, sorry lah. But after this, I will try my best to help lah. If you ask me anything, I will try my best. Okay, thank you.
Alright, thank you, Dr. Charil, for the very encouraging sharing session, very energetic sharing session. Yeah, we understand the challenges when we move to a new place. And first run without testing, it is very difficult and very challenging. So hope our lecturer will benefit with this session. So Dr. Shari will share the slide presentation with me, and then Adek will share to all the participants. And on top of that, we also will be sharing the recorded video. Okay, Dr. Syarif, boleh eh? Recorded video. Tapi kita letak dekat platform ni lah. Kita punya
Okay.
Okay, sebab tadi ada ringtone tadi, ada copyright lah.
That issue dia sebenarnya. Issue dia the copyright lah right now. Memang issue. Careful lah, be careful.
Okay. So, thank you everyone. Please do remember to give your feedback on the link that we provided in the chat session there. No other question, I think we stop our session here. And those who still have a question, maybe they can post to Dr. Syarif. Boleh ya, Dr. Syarif? All right. Okay, thank you very much. Photo session. Let's have a photo session before we leave. Umo ataupun siapa-siapa daripada adek office can help us to snap a photo. And those who with camera, maybe you can turn on your camera for a short time so that we can capture this moment. Umur boleh tolong ambil gambar. Umur?
Dah, saya dah snap.
Dah snap dah? So kita ada berapa screen? I believe we have tadi maximum we got I think around 57.
Ramai eh, ingatkan tak ramai.
Now maybe now we have 33 participants.